know more such amazing stories from Indian history, click the bell icon and subscribe to Live History India.
Mumbai has a small knit Christian community, the history of which can be traced to as early as 600 CE. The culture and art of the community represents a coming together of India and the West. At the Roman Catholic St. Pius Seminary in the western suburb of Goregaon in Mumbai, you will find the Archdiocesan Heritage Museum, a repository of some of the most exquisite objects from the Archdiocese of Bombay, which extends from Colaba in the south to Bhayandar in the north and Lonavala to the east. But this exquisite art was almost lost. With changing tastes, many churches were replacing their historic objects with new ones, relegating these treasures to the storage. Thankfully, Father Warner D'Souza, a Catholic priest in the Archdiocese of Bombay, realized the potential magnitude of this loss and convinced his higher-ups to intervene. He tells us how the museum came to be.
The Archdiocesan Heritage Museum is now 9 years old, but really the history of it goes to almost about 12 or 13 years old. We realized that in Bombay, among the churches, every time I visited a church, I realized that things in a way were disappearing. You see, there was always this clamor for the new, the glitzy, the shiny, and so beautiful old pieces were being replaced by modern statues and modern artifacts. And I went at that point of time to the Archbishop of Bombay, who was Cardinal Ivan, and we convinced him at that point of the need to start what we now call a heritage committee, one that would care for the artifacts of Bombay and its churches. Gradually, we felt a need to collect all of these. And so we began collecting these places in this very space, which was at that point of time used by the seminary as a little gymnasium. It was also partially a storeroom. We had a substantial collection, and at that point of time we realized we needed to set up a museum. By then we had a new archbishop in Bombay, who is the present Cardinal Oswald Gracious. And we went to him and I told him, I said, we need to start a new museum. And he looked at me and very gently said, you know that you're a priest first. And I said, yes, I know, but allow us to do this work. And he did. A few months into this collection, we had such a substantial amount that we invited him to see it. And he was really amazed by the collection. And since then, he's been our principal patron and the one under whom this museum is run. The collection of this museum really comes from approximately about 125 churches that make together the Archdiocese of Bombay. The Archdiocese of Bombay at one time spanned from Bombay all the way to Karachi. And then over a period of time, due to pastoral needs, it was bifurcated. This collection really are from pieces that are found from Colaba in the south to Bhayandar in the north, and then on the eastern side, we go all the way up to Raigad, and then to Lonavala.
The museum has some fascinating objects of deep spiritual and historic importance. The assistant director of the museum, Joanel Fernandez, introduces us to one of them, an altarpiece which has been dated to the 1600s and was found in Manori in the suburb of Malad.
The Archdiocesan Heritage Museum is full of fascinating stories that are manifested through its wonderful objects that could date back to the 1600s. So one such a very fascinating object is the retabler. Now, the retabler is basically an altar screen. The retabler that we are talking about comes to us from the Church of Our Lady of Perpetual Succor, Manori. This beautiful altarpiece is an mixture of two important or two unique features of art. One is the Indian, the second the Portuguese, and together it can be called the Indo-Portuguese style of art. So very interestingly, you can see that the topmost section has these two beautiful leaf motifs. The first, the acanthus. This is a more European motif. It symbolizes eternal life. Then you have a panel that has the vine leaves. The vine in Christian faith is dedicated to the blood of Jesus. So quite prominently, we can see the two angels that flank either sides of a little niche. These angels are completely Indian in character.
The establishment of the museum wasn't without challenges. In the early days, the museum had no resources and very limited support. The objects weren't in the best condition, and the museum didn't have personnel to carry out the technical processes. But people offered support over the years. Father Werner firmly believes that passion helps carry one through.
I think the key word to starting any museum, any collection, anything that you really love is passion. And when you're passionate about something, you continue to work, then you don't look at hurdles. Did we have hurdles? Yes. I mean, it started with the Archbishop of Bombay very subtly telling me, this is not your principal ministry. But we didn't close shop. We believed in something, and so we continued to do it. So don't give up. You know, you'll always face difficulties. I remember we had no money, but people came in and chipped in. So challenges will always come. Opportunities come knocking your way in the strangest of ways. I remember that when we first opened this museum, I didn't even know what a valuable and beautiful collection we had. And we didn't have anybody to curate it. We didn't have anyone even to restore some of our pieces, which were in terrible condition because they were stored really badly. Don't give up. I think I want to say this to everybody. If you have something close to your heart, no matter what it is, follow your dreams. Yeah.
What also helped was the large-heartedness of people. Individuals from all walks of life, like cardinals, priests, historians, architects, restorers, and lay parishioners came together. They helped and supported the museum in various stages of its development, and many of them continue to play a pivotal role today.
Principally, what made this museum work was the help of a couple, Mr. and Mrs. Murthy. They came in and they helped us really restore this entire museum. And then God always works beautifully. So we had Ainsley Lewis, the architect, who came in. He designed the entire place for us. We also had another heritage conservation architect, David Cardoz. We had Fleur de Souza, who's a historian. All of them worked together on the beautiful timeline of this museum that tells the story of the Archdiocese of Bombay in relation to events that happened in the world, in relation to events that took place in Bombay itself.
The museum's work goes far beyond being a repository of historic objects. It chronicles the story of the Catholic Church for future generations to get a better understanding of their heritage. It helps the community engage with its own history and heritage.
It was really created to narrate the story of Christians in this area. In the Archdiocese of Bombay, how the Archdiocese grew. We also use it to interact with the community. So we invite members of the community. Practically every weekend and every week, we have large groups of either youth or children or mixed groups or senior citizens, all who come here, and they spend time. We don't just allow people to come here and look and walk away. We like to engage with them. We talk to them. And in doing this, we kind of allow them to relive the memories, especially the older ones, of what this Christian community in Bombay was all about. For the younger people, it's a point of education. This museum also becomes a great engaging point with the community at large. We have people who are Hindus, Muslims, Parsis, all of whom who come here. And it's extremely wonderful because a lot of prejudices really dissolve in conversation. So this is a great meeting point, small as it is, but it opens many hearts and many doors.
We hope that the Archdiocesan Heritage Museum continues documenting and highlighting the history and culture of the small yet significant Christian community and inspires other communities to do the same.